Good morning, everybody. Change of plans. We are going to be in Macedonia for longer than I thought we were going to be. People keep telling me that I should just wear my backpack rather than having it on my bike. This backpack is really fucking heavy. You might be wondering what the change of plans are, and I don't want to tell you yet because I'm not entirely sure that they're going to play out, but we need to head back to the city we were just in. It's called Skopje. I don't know how to pronounce it. We're heading to the capital city. Fucking hell, I still don't have internet, which means fucking hell. Wait a minute. I had a bed and a pillow here at some point, and I don't anymore. Where the fuck did they go? I must have lost them yesterday because I didn't even go to the hotel with them or the apartment with them. Fucking fuck. I literally used that bed one time. If I had to guess, I would say that they all fell out when my tent fell out yesterday, and just the kids didn't bring that stuff over with them. Fuck. So that means we can't camp until we get a new bed and a new pillow. You might be wondering what our plans changed to and why we are heading back to the capital city. There's a girl. Oh my God, and this is one of those countries that closes everything down on Sundays. So I don't have internet and I don't have cafes. Wow, starting to be a pretty good day. I'm coming to the cell phone store just to super check that they are closed on Sundays, and it does look like it. Yeah, they're locked up. Luckily, the capital city is only 33 miles away, so it's not that far. It'll take like 3 hours to get there, though. We've got a lot of really bad dirt roads, so we can't ride fast. Which means that dirt road that we walked up yesterday, we get to go ride down and then potentially ride back up in the future. It's turning into a great day. So what this means is that I need to find a better way to actually store my stuff, because just sticking it in there and hoping that friction holds it clearly isn't working. First off, I think we should stop at another hardware store and make some kind of like door that I can put over this and latch it so that none of this stuff can slide backward. But I should also find, I should make something so that I can attach stuff to the side right here and right here so I can stick a bed and a pillow without worrying about them falling off. I'm not sure what I want to do, because I feel like it's kind of risky to try to hit the road if I don't have cell data, because if I get hit by a car, if my bike breaks, I can't call for help. So, like, I feel like hitting the road right now is not a good idea. We might want to wait until tomorrow, until we can actually get internet and then hit the road. Coincidentally, this means that we need to go back to the capital anyway, because there's not another major city for like 1,000 miles, which means if we want to be able to get another bed, we need to go back to the biggest city that's got the sports stores. Otherwise, we won't be sleeping in a tent until we hit the coast. Let's see if any restaurants are open that might be interested in selling us food. Okay, I found an ATM, that's convenient. If we don't have internet, we definitely want cash. They didn't charge me any fees at all. I think this might be my favorite country. Halk Bank, it's fantastic. I have no idea how much money I got. Actually, I don't know what the conversion rate is. I got 5,000 Macedonia money. I have no idea how much that's worth, and without internet, I can't check. This is seriously the only Balkan country I've been to that does not have ATM fees. I'm pretty sure this is my favorite one now. It doesn't look on the surface like any of the restaurants are open. I take it back, I found one. It's called Strada Cafe. Actually, I'm not sure if they sell food or if it's just a cafe. Can I get a cappuccino? And orange juice. Oh, thank you so much. I've never had a cappuccino with whipped cream before. Thank you. Yeah, no, this is new. That's really good. Okay, this is definitely not a cappuccino. I don't know what it is, but it's really good. The orange juice is really good too. Apparently the city is called Skopje. Skopje. Thank you. Okay, let's go. Okay, we are headed to the capital city called Skopje. Skopje. There is the lake from yesterday. I won't lie, I am not looking forward to this road. It's really bad condition up ahead and it's like straight uphill. I remember because it was really bad condition yesterday, except I was going downhill, so it was okay. We're getting to the parts of the bad road. Oh no. You know what? This road is actually really bad and really bumpy. It is possible that I lost the inflatable bed somewhere on this road, and I'll find it again going back. That's possible. This is the last bit of good road before we hit it. This nasty stuff right here. Sorry, I had to slow down. Yeah, now we're on the super not fun part of the road. People keep asking me why I don't mount the camera like right here so you guys can see what I'm looking at. That I kind of do, but it requires me manually taking this guy off and then switching him around. And I can do that, but the problem with switching this backward is that in situations where there's like really fast cars or something unexpected happens, it's really easy to just push this button and then you guys can see my face and you can hear what I'm talking about. If I have this guy flipped around to where it's seeing the other side of the bike, you end up missing a lot of like me. The only times that I actually do switch the camera around like this are in situations like this, where the road is really bumpy and I want you guys to see what kind of terrain I'm actually driving on. This is for when I need both hands on the steering wheel and the road is bad. Let's go take this road. It looks like we are about to be back on good concrete and I did not find the bed. If the bed fell off during the route, it would have fallen off there, but I didn't see the bed, so this is a much nicer road. Okay. It wants me to go down that same steep dirt path we went down yesterday. And the only reason I would consider doing that rather than just staying on this road is because my bed might be down there. That was really bumpy, there was a lot of falling over. It's entirely possible that my bed fell on this path. The only way we're gonna know is if I open up my footage from yesterday and actually look at it. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go stop over here, we're gonna crack open my laptop, and we're gonna see if it's worth it to go down that hill. I'm pretty sure I still have the footage. I don't think I deleted it yet. Okay, you guys can't see it because it's bright outside, but I do see my bed on that. My bed was attached to this while I was going up that hill. So, hey, look at this. Do you guys remember when my bike fell over on that stand yesterday? There is no bed in there, which means I lost the bed before the kids found my tent. I lost my bed somewhere after this and somewhere before the river. Fuck it, we're going down the steep dirt road. It might be there. God, vlogging has so many cool perks. Because I vlogged this, I can pinpoint almost exactly where I lost my bed at. I'm not sure if I want to try riding down it or not. I probably could. Going down is easier than going up. Let's give it a go. Nope, do not like. We're walking. So, thinking about it, I probably did lose my bed on that really road back there, but there's a lot of bicyclists around here. I bet somebody saw the bed and they're like, oh, hey, a free inflatable bed. I bet somebody picked it up. It's bright blue. I would have seen it if it was there. God, I'm so glad I didn't try to ride down this. Nope, nope, nope. Yeah, we haven't found the bed yet, which means I don't think we will. Nope, no bed. A bunch of trash, but no bed. So you guys know how I complain that this app sends me down really weird routes, but then I proceed to go down the really weird route myself. I think I might be reinforcing this app and telling it that its routes are okay. Like, I think that by actually following its instructions, it's getting the impression that the things it's telling me are right. Back on the cycleway. Bike lanes are great. See, this is what worries me when people say that a country is biker friendly. Like, just because it has bike lanes doesn't mean that the people treat it like it's not a parking lot. I'm not sure if it's open because it's Sunday, but I really hope we can get lunch at the same place we got yesterday because they had really good rice. Oh wait, no, it's locked up. Yeah, rip. I do still have their Wi-Fi password though, so that's cool. So we will just not eat. That seems to be the plan. Who needs food on Sundays? Hey, we are gonna stop at this little market here because it's open and it might be the only food we get for a while. I don't know why I thought there would be food here. Let's get some pretzels with peanuts, yes. That's good, I like that. This is about $1.50. Oh, they've got some granola bars too. Let's get some of these. I got a bunch of snacks. Oh my God. Oh wow, that's really good. It's not a protein bar, it's a granola bar. I think it's actually like a rice bar. I even made sure to buy some snacks for later, for future Sunday shenanigans. This whole thing is less than $5, all of this, plus the granola bar I just ate. Like, Macedonia is really cheap, and I like that. And they don't have ATM fees, which I really like. But I can't support a place that closes down one day of the week, every single week. Like, you guys have heard me call Austria a shitty country. This is why. There's nothing wrong with Austria aside from the fact that once a week, everything just stops. Notice another almost invisible speed bump. He's just riding his scooter in the middle of the street without a helmet, by the way. It says there's a road through here. I'm pretty sure there's not. Okay, maybe there is if we go on the sidewalk. Let me see.
Take the next right, then in 350 feet turn left onto Vihaga.
Maybe we can get through here. I'm pretty sure this is not supposed to be. You're not supposed to take your bike through this, but we're doing it anyway. It literally could have just kept me on the road, but it didn't. It had me go literally through a fucking building. We are about 1 mile away. Booking.com? Yes, hello. Fantastic. Perfect, this works. Okay, let's go get all of the things off the bike. This is a cool little place, actually. Oh, and she says that there is a mall here with an A1 that is open on Sundays, so where we can actually get sell data today in a mall. The bike battery only has 20% left, where we might leave the bike here and let it charge and then just walk to the mall. The first thing she asks when she sees me on the bike is she's like, is this a bike or a motorcycle? Okay, cool. Let's go proceed to get internet. The mall now.
Have a nice day.
Google says it's a 21-minute walk. I'm not gonna lie, I love this. Being able to walk around a city and enjoy it without constantly being worried about my stuff getting stolen. I was talking to the receptionist back at the apartment as to why it is that Macedonia closes down on Sundays, and apparently this is legislation to try to get them into the EU. They're like changing themselves to make themselves seem more European. They literally changed their name just to possibly be able to get into the EU. I'm not gonna lie though, aside from the small little hiccup that is every Sunday, I think that Macedonia might be my favorite Baltic country. Serbia was fine, but it was kind of unimpressive. There was nothing special about it. Kosovo, the top half of Kosovo was a nightmare. I felt like I was gonna die all the time. The bottom half of Kosovo was fantastic. So the average is out to like a B. I would say that if I was only judging the bottom half of Kosovo, I would give it a much higher rank. Albania was very pretty, but I feel like the businesses there were a little bit shady, and Montenegro was very expensive. I think that Macedonia is my favorite. Okay, it's my favorite 6 out of 7 days of the week, so that means it averages out to like a 92. All of these restaurants have shuttered their doors, and they're on like a main street. Oh hey, I found a bicycle shop. We might be able to get more mirrors here. They're closed because it's Sunday, of course, but tomorrow we'll come back and see if we can't get more bike mirrors. Here we are, the big mall that is open on Sundays. I see there is an Istanbul cafe there, which means we might even be able to get some lahmacun. Then again, it is just a cafe, so I doubt they have a pizza oven. Nope. Here we are, the cell phone store. I bought a SIM card at a grocery store yesterday for A1, but they couldn't activate it because I'm a US citizen. Okay, they gave me a number that I'm supposed to call. I call this number, I wait 20 minutes, and apparently I've got 20 gigabytes. Pretty sure the food court is up this way. I think I see some things that are open. Oh, there's a Burger King. They have lahmacun. What a great day. We are right next to a place that serves lahmacun. And we have cell data again. Fantastic. Oh, they look fantastic. I am so excited. Thank you so much. Oof. They're big. They're way bigger than I thought they would be. Yeah, I was expecting these to be smaller, but they gave me unlimited lemons, so that's cool. They didn't cut them. I just realized that. They're not cut. So I'm just gonna let you guys know right now, there is a fairly good chance this is the only thing we're gonna eat for the entire time we are in Macedonia. I kind of wonder if there's a candy store in here somewhere. There could also be a sports store. We might be able to just replace the bed right now. I would have to walk back to the apartment with it, but that's fine. I don't see any sporting goods stores. This seems like it's got a large assortment of stuff. I think this might be the closest store I've seen in my entire travels in Europe to a Walmart. They've got kids' toys and blankets, grills, kitchenware. We just need to find tents. I do not see a sporting goods section. They do have Allen wrenches though, so they're better than Kosovo. Nope, no dice. Nope, I don't think there's a sporting goods store here. We got internet and we got food. I'm gonna call that success. So it seems like the TV does not have an HDMI cable, so I can't plug my laptop up to this and use it. Okay, so I have plans to meet up with the girl tomorrow. Yeah, I will catch you guys then, I guess. Holy shit, I almost dropped my phone. Holy shit, that,